Wall Street, central banks, and retail investors have one thing in common: their growing interest in cryptocurrencies. According to CoinShares, inflows into crypto funds and products hit a record $4.5 billion in the first quarter of this year.
There's $140 trillion of U.S. wealth, $400 trillion of global wealth. So we're now up to half a percent of global wealth is in crypto, and that's growing. I think it'll be a percent by the end of the year.
Bitcoin gets the most attention among its crypto peers, but critics of digital currencies raise concerns about their structure and their volatility.
I don't completely buy the whole thing. You're essentially saying that we're going to create a store of value and a medium of exchange around something that only exists inside of a computer somewhere.
Bitcoin is not having any income, doesn't have any users, doesn't have liquidity services, doesn't have any utility. What's the intrinsic value of it? It's just a self-fulfilling bubble.
Beyond Bitcoin, it's the underlying technology of blockchain that is attracting investor interest. According to CB Insights, startups focusing on blockchain raised about $2.5 billion in just the first quarter of this year, outpacing the amount raised in all of 2020.
What it's really doing is it's building an infrastructure to actually transact on.
Central banks are also feeling the pressure to create their own central bank digital currencies. A recent survey by the Bank for International Settlements found that 86% of central banks are currently engaged, up from 65% in 2017.
What the central bank is essentially trying to do right now is a version, a very mild version of, if you can't beat them, join them. They're almost trying to disintermediate the disintermediators.
The motivation for central banks has been partly to guard against the risk of financial exclusion or digital dollarization if payments shift to privately controlled alternatives.
I do wonder whether at this point Bitcoin should also be thought in part of as a Chinese financial weapon against the U.S., where it threatens fiat money, but it especially threatens the U.S. Dollar.